Thanks, Miro. All right, now time for a little money talk. Yeah. Retirement used to be a promise you could bake on, but our financial analyst Hank Parrott says not anymore. We welcome you back, Hank, to Talk of the Town. Now, let's talk about this, because our parents and our grandparents had certain things. They had those pensions, they had Social Security, and that safety net of life savings. Folks my age, it's 401ks and a couple of other things, but still we're in that situation for a lot of folks of what happened to my happily ever after.
Exactly, because I mean, with parents and grandparents, their life, what they were able to do is live on that pension and Social Security, so the savings they didn't have to touch. So things that the risks that we have today, they didn't have. So an example would be when we start taking money out of those retirement accounts, that subjects us to some additional risks that they didn't have to deal with.
All right, so you're talking about risk, and there are a couple of things that we need to be mindful of. Let's first off talk about longevity risk. What does that mean?
There we go. So longevity risk, that we know now, an average for a 65-year-old male, average life expectancy is age 86. Mm-hmm. For an average 65-year-old woman, is age 89. Now again, that's the average, which means that half of us are gonna live longer than that. So when we're living 25 years into retirement, think about if you retire at 65, God forbid you died at 68, well, if the market drops 3,000 points, that doesn't affect you. Long-term care, that's not going to be a problem. The longevity, the longer we live, the more these risks come in. Inflation is another. Price is going up.
Okay.
Not going to affect, but if we live 20, 25 years, that's going to be a big, big impact on us.
All right. So retirement age has been raised a bit. At one point, it was 65. For me, now it's 67. Right. Will that get raised, do you think, down the line?
One of the fixes for Social Security that's been talked about, in fact, is just that. Another is to raise the cap on how much you pay in. So right now, if you make it $118,000 or more a year, you stop paying into Social Security. You still pay Medicare, but not Social Security. That's approximately 5.65 at that point. So that'll go away, but now that's something they're talking about raising. So taking either the cap off or raising the cap so people that make more will continue paying into the system.
All right, so let's talk now about sequence of return risk.
Right, and this is one of those where longevity comes in again. So imagine again, if I retire, 2000 through 2002, the market dropped 44% approximately. So if in that same time I retired, now I'm having to take money out of my retirement account.
Mm-hmm.
So if I'm taking, let's say I have $500,000 that I have saved up in my retirement accounts, and I'm going to take 4%. This used to be considered a very safe withdrawal rate.
Yeah.
So I'm taking $20,000 a year. Now I want that $20,000 to increase for inflation, so it's going to go up. But over that 3-year period, market dropped 44. That means I would have lost about over $200,000 of my $500,000 just in market losses.
Okay.
In addition, I took out another $60,000 for income. So now all of a sudden, I'm 3 years into retirement, and my $500,000. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. It's down around 230 to 40,000.
Okay, so I got to watch that now. Then inflation risk.
Yes, inflation risk is the other. So if you look at what it would cost today, so if I'm making $50,000 that to cover my lifestyle expenses, so I need $50,000 a year to live on today. 10 years from today, at a 3% inflation rate, then I need about $67,000 a year to pay those same things, just to maintain my standard of living. No improvements, just to maintain it over that 10-year period. Now, if I live 20 years, there's longevity risk, right?
Mm-hmm.
All of a sudden, that 67% gets increased even more. Now I'm gonna need over $80,000, $85,000, $90,000 even to cover the same amount.
All right, so a lot of great information there, but more we can delve into. Thank you so very much for being with us today. Now, if you need to delve into more of that, you can call Hank every Friday morning between 8 and 9 o'clock. He is on the Retirement Report on News Channel 5 Plus. So again, there are other great questions that you probably have. Call him between 8 and 9 on News Channel 5 Plus every Friday morning. And we'll also link you to his website from ours at newschannel5.com.